Hello everyone, in this video we will learn about menstrual cycle. The reproductive cycle in the female primate, example monkey, apes and human being is called the menstrual cycle. That means whatever the cycle that is occur at the time of reproductive phase, we called it menstrual cycle. Now the first menstruation begins at puberty and it's called menarche. So whenever the first menstrual cycle starts at the age of 13 to 14 or 12 years, so 12 to 14 years, first menstrual cycle starts, and that is known as the menarche. So whenever the puberty occurs or puberty starts, at that time the first menstrual cycle starts, and that first menstrual cycle is known as the menarche. So in human females, menstruation is repeated at an average interval of about 28 to 29 days, and the cycle of event starting from one menstruation till the next one is called the menstrual cycle. So that means whenever we are talking about the menstrual cycle, so it is an average of 28 to 29 days. So during this duration, this cycle repeats. And the menstrual cycle, when it starts from one menstruation till the next one. So when first menstruation starts and again the next menstruation starts. So between these two periods is known as the menstrual cycle. Now the ovum is released during the middle of the menstrual cycle. Now the cycle starts with the menstrual phase. That means whenever the menstrual flow starts, at that time the cycle is begin. And it lasts for 3 to 5 days. So whenever the menstrual cycle started, at that time the menstrual flow is occur and it lasts for 3 to 5 days. Now the menstrual flow result due to the breakdown of endometrium lining of the uterus and its blood vessels, which forms a liquid that is coming out through the vagina. So whatever the endometrium is there, we told early that the uterus that is containing the inner lining, and that inner lining is known as the endometrium. So whenever this endometrium starts breaking and whatever the blood vessels are there, it will also start bursting, and that time it will makes a flow, and that flows when it is coming out from the vagina, we called it menstrual flow. Now menstruation only occur if the released ovum is not fertilized. Means whatever the ovum is coming out from the ovary, if it is not fertilized or fertilization is not occur, at that time the menstruation occur. If the ovum is fertilized, at that time the pregnancy occur. So lack of menstruation may be indicative of pregnancy. But it is saying maybe, means it may be also occur. That means menstruation will not occur at the time of stress or poor health. So if any person is suffering from stress or poor health, at that time also the menstruation will not occur. So it is only a indicative. It is not a confirm that the person is pregnant. So whenever the menstruation occurs, that means a person is normal. It is not pregnant. But if the menstruation is not occur, though maybe it is pregnant. Now the menstrual phase is followed by the follicular phase. During this phase, the primary follicle in the ovary grows to become the fully mature graafian follicle, and simultaneously the endometrium of the uterus regenerates through prolification. Means in menstrual cycle, whenever the menstrual phase starts, after that the follicular phase will start. And in this phase, what is happening, whatever the primary follicles are there, it will convert into the graafian follicle, and simultaneously whatever the endometrium is there, it will also start thicken due to prolification. So two things are happening. First of all, after menstrual phase, what is happening, the primary follicles are first converted into the graafian follicles, and simultaneously at that time the lining of the endometrium, it will also thick. Now what are the changes are occur in ovary and uterus? It is induced by the level of pituitary and ovarian hormone. So whenever these hormones are changing or their level are changing, at that time the ovary and uterus are also getting a change. So whatever the changes are occur in ovary and uterus, it is basically induced by the level of pituitary and ovarian hormone. Now the releasing of gonadotropins. We know that the two type of gonadotropins are there, LH एंड एफ एस एच. एल एस इज अ ल्यूटिलाइजिंग हार्मोन एंड एफ एस एच फॉलिकुलर स्टिम्युलेटिंग हार्मोन. सो वैन दीज टू हार्मोन्स आर इंक्रीज ग्रेजुअली ड्यूरिंग द फॉलिकुलर फेज एंड इट ऑल्सो स्टिम्युलेट्स द फॉलिकुलर डेवलपमेंट एज वेल एज द सिक्रेशन ऑफ एस्ट्रोजन बाय द ग्रोइंग फॉलिकल्स. सो वॉट इज हैपनिंग वेन एवर दीज गोनेडोट्रोफिन्स आर रिलीज एट दैट टाइम, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द फॉलिकुलर फेज विल स्टिम्युलेट एंड ऑल्सो इट विल स्टिम्युलेट द सिक्रेशन ऑफ एस्ट्रोजन बाय द ग्रोइंग फॉलिकल्स. ना बोथ एल एच एंड एफ एस एच अटेन अ पीक लेवल इन द मिडिल साइकिल अबाउट 14 डे. सो एट द 14 डे और द मिडिल साइकिल वॉट इज हैपनिंग द लेवल ऑफ एल एच एंड द एफ एस एच इट इज ऑन द पीक. दैट मीन्स इट इज द हाइएस्ट ऑन द लेवल. ना रिपीट रैपिड सिक्रेशन ऑफ द एल एच लीडिंग टू इट्स मैक्सिमम लेवल ड्यूरिंग द मिडिल और मिड साइकिल इज कॉल्ड द एल एच सर्ग. सो वेन एवर द लेवल ऑफ द एल एच इज ऑन द टॉप और द हाई देन वी कॉल्ड इट एल एच सर्ग. एंड वेन एवर दिस एल एच सर्ग अकर एट दैट टाइम इट इंड्यूस द रप्चर ऑफ ग्रेफिन फॉलिकल एंड देयर बाय द रिलीजिंग ऑफ ओवम. दैट मीन्स द ओवुलेशन विल अकर. सो वेन एवर द एल एच सर्ग इज देयर at that time the graafian follicle will burst or it will break, it will release the ovum that we call the ovulation. Now the ovulation or the ovulatory phase is followed by the luteal phase. So what is luteal phase? During which the remaining part of the graafian follicle transform as the corpus luteum. So whenever the graafian follicles burst, it will release the ovum. So whatever the rest part of the graafian follicle, it will convert into the corpus luteum and that phase is known as the luteal phase. Now the corpus luteum secretes large amount of progesterone. So corpus luteum, it will release the progesterone and which is very essential for the maintenance of endometrium. If corpus luteum is not there, it will not release the progesterone and due to that the endometrium will not stable. And this endometrium is very important for the implantation of fertilized ovum. So if the ovum is fertilized at that time, the endometrium should be prepared for accepting it. But if the progesterone is not there, in that case the endometrium will not maintain itself and after some time whenever the pregnancy occurs, it will not able to receive it. So the implantation will not occur. Now during pregnancy, all events of the menstrual cycle stop and there is no menstruation. That means if the pregnancy occur or the ovum is fertilized at that time pregnancy occur and in this duration, whatever the duration is there for pregnancy, at that time no menstrual cycle occur. Now if the fertilization not occur, in that case whatever the corpus luteum is there, it will start degenerating. And due to the degeneration of corpus luteum, the endometrium, it will also start degenerating. The reason, the endometrium will maintain itself only for the fertilized egg. But if the fertilization not occur at that time, whatever the corpus luteum is there, it will start degenerating and due whatever the progesterone is released, it will also decrease. So when the level of progesterone will decrease, the endometrium will also start degenerating and it will cause the menstrual cycle. And whenever the endometrium is degenerate, it will cause or it will result in the making of a new cycle. Now in human beings, the menstrual cycle chases around 50 years of age. That means a human female can achieve this menstrual cycle or is having the menstrual cycle at the age of till 50 years. After 50 years, they are not having any type of menstrual cycle. Now that is termed as the menopause. That means whenever the last menstrual cycle occur, so that last menstrual cycle is known as the menopause. After that, a human female is not able to pregnant. Now, cyclic menstruation is an indication of a normal reproductive phase and extend between the menarch and menopause. So if the normal menstrual cycle occur, in that case, we can say the human female is normal. It is a quite normal reproductive phase. But if it is not having the proper menstrual cycle, then we can say it is suffering from any problem or any disease. Now this is extend from menarche to the menopause. That means from first menarche, when the first menstrual cycle occurs, So from then to the menopause. So during this period is the sexual period for the human females. Now in this diagram, we can observe the different levels of hormones at different time in menstrual cycle. So in the top, we are having the pituitary hormone level. So in this, we can see the level of FSH is always higher at the starting and at the end. And at the middle of the menstrual cycle, the level of LH is higher. Now in the middle one, there is an indication for the estrogen and progesterone hormone. So we can see at the starting and at the end, the level of estrogen is higher and the progesterone is of always in low level. Now at the middle or at the mid time of the menstrual cycle, at that time what is happening, the level of estrogen is too much high, but after that it will gradually decrease and the level of progesterone will increase. So why the progesterone is increased? Reason, due to the formation of corpus luteum, and this corpus luteum will produce a progesterone that will help in the maintaining of endometrium. In the last, we can observe the condition of endometrium at different time. So at the starting, when the menstrual phases occur, and that means the menstruation occur or the menstrual flow occur, so this is the position of endometrium at that time, and we can see it will gradually increase in thickness. And at the time of luteal phase, when the fertilized ovum is ready to implant in that endometrium, at that time the thickness of endometrium is too much high, and after, when there is no fertilization, the endometrium, it will start gradually decrease in size or decrease in thickness.